or we provide the rule how to calculate the derived representation, let us come back to see what is the relation to the formula or the property for mother wavelet. So we have rho h, the condition for mother wavelet to produce induced wavelet transform, to have that simple eigenvalue property. Now assume we are taking element x in Lie algebra. So H will be Lie algebra of subgroup H tilde, and H will be simply ET to the power X. When we substitute into our property, so we have rho ETX V naught will be a character of this element V naught. So if we will differentiate with respect to t both sides, the if we differentiate with respect to t both sides, the identity will be preserved. And if we make substitution t equal to zero, then identity will be held. And that means that if we will make it on the right hand side, we will have the derived representation for our vector field x acting of v naught will be equal to the number which is calculated as the derived representation of this character. So this is a number, so we may put v naught. So this is certain lambda which appears here. So what we replaced the initial, so this is a functional condition which we have at the beginning, and here we have a certain differential operator acting on v naught produce the eigenvector, or demonstrate that this is eigenvector. So we have differential equation which may be easier to solve. So for our representation induced from the subgroup F, we have this derived representation. So let us see what we have. In this point, we come back again to some additional properties of the wavelet transform. Again, on the previous lecture, if you remember, we when we defined the wavelet transform, we stated its intertwining property. So when we have wavelet transform, when wavelet transform full of it after the group representation is the same as if we do wavelet transform and follow it by the left shift on the group. So that was the simple property which we demonstrated on the previous lecture. Now things here, left shifts, if you again come back on functions on the group, it's map that function to F G inverse G prime. And besides of left shift on any group, we also have right shifts. So right shift is a map which send FG to the FG prime G. For if our group is non-commutative, so multiplication from the left and from the right, in general, different things. So they act differently. Now question is, if left shift after the wavelet transform, this is intertwined with our representation. If I will apply right shift after the wavelet transform, what it will be. So let's do that simple calculation. Again, according to our formula, so right shift of g wavelet transform acting on f, that will be a function defined by the on the group, so g prime. So that will be the right shift acting according to the definition on this inner product f rho g prime on mother wavelet. Then again according to the meaning of the right shift will be rho g prime g v naught, or that will be f of rho g prime rho g v naught, or that will be f rho g prime acting on v1, where v1 is rho of g on v naught. So this is what we obtained. But what we have here is really a wavelet transform. So this is just a formula wavelet transform, just with a different mother wavelet. So this is the wavelet transform with the function f at point g prime. And we need to put here v1, and here probably to specify what it was with respect to v0 wavelet transform. So, and this is how our transformation is acting. So this is simple calculation, is saying what if you have left shift after the wavelet transform, this is intertwined with the representation rho acting on your function f, on signal. And if you have a right representation acting after wavelet transform, this will be, or if you put it again once more, that will be wavelet transform rho g acting on v naught f g prime. So right shift act on mother wavelet. So left shift act on f. So that we have on this picture or that property. So that signal here is transformed by so left shift after the wavelet transform produce action rho on the signal, and here we have action right shift produce action of the mother wavelet. Again, for calculation is not difficult, calculation is relatively simple. Nevertheless, it has interesting consequences. So let's come back to our consideration. So recall that property, and that it's told you if by some chances in this formula I would annihilate the mother wavelet by some action, then wavelet transform will be equal to zero. So this is so in if in this formula that action will produce a zero vector, or linear combination of such action will produce a zero vector, when wavelet transform with zero vector of course will be zero. So if I able to annihilate mother wavelet, then entire wavelet transform will be annihilated. So here is our statement. So if we have, if we are able to annihilate mother wavelet by means of certain action of our Lie algebra, so linear combination of derived representation with some coefficient, when the entire Waverley transform by this intertwining property which we demonstrated will be annihilated by corresponding right operator shifts. So this is what follows from our formula. So in particular, that give us a connection with the Cauchy-Riemann and Laplace operator in complex analysis. So if we will be able to choose a mother wavelet such what it is annihilated by some vector in the corresponding derived representation, then entire wavelet transform will disappear. So let's come back to our representation which we have. So this is representation of on the real line generated by the affine group, induced by the affine subgroup, is a representation of cell to A. So for vector A from the basis, which produce diagonal matrices, and for subgroup subgroup N, which consists of our triangular matrices, we may calculate corresponding derived representation. So it's f of x, x f prime, and for n it will be just f prime. When we may check what the derived representation linear combination of A and N for with coefficient I will produce an operator which annihilate a function 1 over x plus I. So it's null solution to that thing. That means what after we will do the Waverley transform with this function, the resulting function will be annihilated by corresponding right shift operators, and this right shift operator is exactly Cauchy-Riemann operator. So if we will do the Waverley transform with this vector, then result will consist of analytical function. So this is elements of complex analysis which we are recovering. So if you will use that function, what we will obtain, as we will see, it's a Cauchy kernel, and when corresponding functions are after applying Cauchy integral formula, we will be analytical. So now we are putting all things together. So what we will have discussed so far to recover the complex analysis first. So we consider the eigenvalue property for the derived representation. So if we start from that condition on the subgroup, the derived version for subgroup K, so we are working with subgroup K. Subgroup K is generated by element Z of Lie algebra basis, which we have seen. So we are looking for eigenvectors for derived action. Again, what is derived action for Z was calculated before. This is this operator. And this shall happen for some lambda. This is a first order differential equation, rather easy to solve, and generic solution of that first order differential operator would be such a function. So that expression is a generic solution of this function, or if we slightly adjust it, we will get that fraction. Now, because here there is a complex powers, and we don't want to have multi-valued functions on the real line, the condition will be what lambda here is just the integer times imaginary unit. Otherwise, expression x minus I to that power will produce multivalued function on the real line. So that is necessary condition here, which appears, and it's come from the compactness of subgroup K. So because subgroup K is compact, so its dual group in the sense of duality would be discrete. So when you have a unit circle and do Fourier transform, you get Fourier series with discrete coefficients. So that is again manifestation what we really need to put here, integer value of lambda. Now potentially you can use any of this function to as mother wavelengths. Whenever you use this function, this is an eigenfunction for subgroup K, so result of induced wavelet transform will be a function on the homogeneous space SL to R factor K. SL to R factor K, we studied it in geometrical part of the course, is upper half plane of complex numbers. So with any such kernel for any n and any m, you will get some integral transform from real line. Again, the picture is as follow. So our function is initially defined on the real line, so here, which in our language turned to be a homogeneous space SL to R over F. So we started from this representation on the real line. Wavelet transform put this function to the function because we choose mother wavelet to be eigenfunction of subgroup K, it's turn it to the function on the homogeneous space SL to R over K, which is complex numbers with positive real part, imaginary part, positive imaginary part. So this is what we discussed in the geometry course. So our wavelet transform with such function will be transformation from one domain, real line, from one set to the another set, upper half plane. And that come out of the properties of the group which we used, and that integral transform. And potentially you can use any such kernel to have a transformation. But here if you put an additional condition, what you want image will consist of functions which are annihilated by something, when you use the differential operator from the previous identity. And if you will look what it means here, it is just exactly the condition m equal to n, and when after you reduce here by this condition, you will get the function which we seen on the previous slide, that will be 1 over x plus I. This is the mother wavelet which have both properties. So it's eigenfunction for subgroup K and it's annihilated by some operator. And when wavelet transform, you do it according to the formula. So FU times the transformation of the given x plus I, 1 over x plus I, that will be that expression for the Cauchy integral formula which we recovered in this case. And also it's possible to use other parameters m higher than n, but this time your mother wavelet will be annihilated not by this operator, but it will be annihilated by some power of this operator. If you apply several times that operator, that it will annihilate the functions with higher value of m in this case. And that again, in exactly by the previous theorem, it will tell you what the image will consist not from analytic function, not from function which annihilated by Cauchy-Riemann operator, but by functions which annihilated by some power of Cauchy-Riemann operator. So not by first order, but some higher power of Cauchy-Riemann operator. And such functions also of interest were called polyanalytic. So if a function annihilated by n power of Cauchy-Riemann operator, it's called polyanalytic function of order n. So were also studied. So what we will obtain here really the collection not only of Cauchy integral formula, but also integral representation for polyanalytic function of higher order as well. So as you can see, just applying the general consideration, we recovered quite important piece of standard complex analysis and even advanced complex analysis, which include polyanalytic functions. Now let us see if we may use that technique in some other situations. So coming back, here is the again connection of the geometry. As you can see, there is all that parts of the course are connected. So what was happen with geometrical part when we spoke about action of subgroup K, when subgroup K act on the real light transitively. So we have all that rotation, so any point of the real line, but action of subgroup K can be transferred to any other point of the real line. So if we will move to subgroup A, then there is a difference. So so subgroup K fixed imaginary unit, and on the upper half plane this is fixed point, but there is no fixed point on the real axis for subgroup K. If we look for subgroup A, then it's fixed imaginary unit here, and it also fixed the light cone passing imaginary unit, and that light cone intersect real axis in two points, minus one and one. So for subgroup A, there are two fixed points on the real axis, so minus one and one. So there are four orbits here. So the open interval from minus one to one, this is one orbit. Any point within that interval may be mapped to any point into that interval. Point minus one is fixed point, its orbit itself. Point one is fixed point, its orbit itself. When complement to interval minus one, one through infinity, so this is one orbit. So points with absolute value more than one can be transferred one to another by action of subgroup A. That means now that presence of this fixed point affect solution of our differential equation. So because what we will do now for subgroup A prime, if you will come to the basis of SL2R in term which we introduced, it's generated by element B of our basis, matrix 0, 1, what is it, 1, 0. So element B is 0, 1, 1, 0. So that generates subgroup A prime in exponentiation. And so derivative so for B was calculated. This is this function. Again, that is differential equation on the real line, but it has two singular points, minus one and one, which we recover from the geometry. And so solution is not defined on the entire real line. Solution to that differential equation is defined for interval minus one, one, or with fixed point minus one and one as the distribution, and so forth. Let's concentrate on that interval minus one, one. So what is the solution? So if we solve that differential equation, we will see what the function is rather similar to what we had before. So, but this time we do not have a restriction what m shall be an integer. So we don't need that condition. It appears with complex numbers and follow from compactness of subgroup K. Now that condition is not necessary. Lambda here may be an arbitrary number. real number. And we also have another opportunity. We may even put lambda to be purely imaginary number for double numbers. So we may substitute g to power m, g times m. And then if we will use properties of dual numbers, then what happen really, we will obtain a function like that. And again, if you will come back what we have here, you will see what is exactly this function if you replace I by the j. So you replace the corresponding imaginary unit, and what happened here, you obtain the solution of differential equation on interval minus 1 to 1. That solution is drawn in this case. What we have here a very fast oscillation near to the end point. So that function highly oscillating, and actually we able somehow make very fine resolution what happened nearby to singularities here. So there are some advantages to use it in some situation where we want to have that kind of behavior. So, but again, a lot of things here still to be investigated. Application of that transformation can be investigated. Briefly, what happened in term of previous differential equation or eigenfunction with respect to subgroup A, you may see what if you take a delta function as a distribution at points plus or minus 1, that will be again eigenfunction for the subgroup A prime. So it will be also such as a distribution. Or you can use these functions on the interval minus 1 to 1. And you may also put some linear combination of these different distribution. In this sense, you will get the integral transform from the real axis and to the upper half plane. So coming back, what will happen here? So if you remember when we discuss what follow from algebraic definition of analytic function with double numbers, so it was just a couple of values which you obtain from the light cone. So that is recovered here if you will take that distribution from the endpoints intersection with light cone and real axis. So that condition is recovered. But on top of that, you obtain some integral transform which again act here from the real axis. This is again SL to R with respect to affine subgroup F, but integral transform which you will have here, so it's entire interval which will contribute to the value of the point, and this value of the point belong to SL to R over A prime, and we identify it as the collection of double numbers in the geometrical things under Möbius transformation. So that we will study. So we will have here a certain integral Waverly transform. Again, properties of Waverly transform and properties of corresponding differential operators still to be investigated. In particular here, it's possible to pick up certain differential operators which will annihilate that Mother wavelet, and then corresponding wavelet transform will consist of functions which are annihilated by some differential operators. So that will be hyperbolic equations, hyperbolic similar to the wave equation, but not as simple as wave equation. It will have some additional terms, so solution will be more complicated than with simple solution. So that is a kind of application with similar ideas we may recover for double numbers. Well, if we are doing the same thing in that spirit for the third parabolic case, again we obtain meaningful result. So subgroup n prime, this is a lower triangular matrices, to obtain with subgroup of lower triangular matrices, we need take such a combination of our elements in Lie algebra. So z is that 0, minus 1, 1, 0. B is 0, 1, 1, 0. So if you do that linear combination, you get just lower triangular matrix here. So the derived representation, similarly, because it's a linear operation, can be calculated out as linear combination of derived representation which we did before. So that is a differential operator, a rather simple one. So if we try to solve a differential operator, we will find solution of this differential operator, which is of this type. Well, it looks quite different from what we had before, but recall what we may employ the epsilon with property epsilon squared equal to zero when there are a lot of formulas which simplified according to this calculation. So exponent, for example, is turned to be just first two terms in the Taylor expansion, so it's a linear function of this type. When again, out of the binomial formula, we also have only two terms. And finally, t squared can be factorized into t minus epsilon, t plus epsilon. So using all that formulas together, the term in the that expression, which we have here, lambda over u, can be represented as follow. So you can see it's again similar to what we had before, just imaginary unit I replaced by imaginary unit for dual numbers epsilon, and we again have the same structure, the same fraction what we will obtain. And so in total that is a solution for that that eigenvalue property. So that is some integral kernel. And once more, what we will have, so using such a kernel, we again started from functions defined on the real line, which is homogeneous space SL to R over F. And we make integral transform to the, because we have that homogeneous, we have eigenvalue properties, it come to SL to R over n prime, which is collection of dual numbers with positive imaginary part. So this is where our function will belong to. And again, we have here certain function when we integrate, so value and a point will be depend from entire value, so it will be integration over entire real line. So it's not like with functions as we said before, it was the value from the projection and derivative at the point of the projection. So it will be a real integral which we will obtain in that case. And again, there is a certain differential operator which is annihilating the image space, so some analyticity condition follows, but again, quite a lot of things still need to be investigated where, so besides of just written down the formula for Waverly transform, so besides of that, many properties still waiting attention. Now we are succeeded in the building integral formulas of Cauchy integral type, where we started from the real line and obtained functions in the upper half plane in the corresponding geometries, elliptic, parabolic, and hyperbolic. And after that integral transform, functions was null solution, so was annihilated by certain differential operators. So we recovered Cauchy integral formula and Cauchy Riemann operator. So that two elements of complex analysis are already recovered from group representations. Let us see what happened with other important parts of complex analysis. One of them is Taylor series. So how Taylor series can be approached in this way? In Taylor series, what we may do here for the wavelet, which collection of wavelets which we have, so it's depend, it's a function, or say in our case, on the real line, and it's depend from element of the group G. So it's function of two variables A and G. So what we may expand it into certain sum or maybe integral over a spectral parameter lambda. So this is known as a separation of variables. So we really want to separate variable x and variable g in this way. So it's known in the theory of solution of differential equation as separation of variable. When you are doing that over certain spectral parameter, what shall be appropriate spectral parameter lambda here? So the most natural spectral parameter would be the spectrum of this subgroup H tilde, which we have used to construct mother wavelets. So if we are doing that spectral parameters, then it's easy to see what, so this is the formula for the wavelet transform. So wavelets are expanded to the series using linearity of the inner product. You put that coefficients which independent from Z outside, so you get here an expansion over eigenfunction of subgroup H tilde. So this is eigenfunction of the subgroup H tilde, so you get an expansion. So this is a rather general formula which work in our particular situation, and we have here eigenfunction of subgroup K, for example, on the real line, which we built before. Here spectral parameter M take integer values, as we discussed. If we avoid multi-value functions, we need to put M integer. And effectively, what this function are under Kelly transform, they simply come to the eigenfunction of the rotation of unit circle. So when we do Kelly transform, upper half plane is transformed to the unit disk, and at the unit disk subgroup K act by rotations, and eigenfunction under complex rotation are just powers of Z to the power N. So that Kelly transform shows what we have a usual Taylor expansion. So for this general scheme. If we will start to speak about eigenfunctions, then the following technique is of importance. And this technique is rooted in the representation theory, but it's originally was created by physicists who labeled it creation annihilation operator, or raising-lowering operator in context of quantum mechanics. So again, this is something which we have discussed on other occasions. So in quantum mechanics, a typical maybe primary object for investigation, for understanding, was an atom. And say in very simple situation, in hydrogen atom, you have a positron and then electron rotating around, and electron can take just a discrete number of orbits, so it's have exciting states. And if some energy is supplied, say photon is absorbed, then electron is passing from one discrete orbit to higher discrete orbit, so energy absorbed here. Or it may be opposite transition when electron emit photons, and when it go to lower energy orbit, and so that produce that spectral lines which we mentioned in our course. So when you may just count that number of photons observed, and that create or destroy energy level in hydrogen atom. So physicists use that operators which put atom from one state to another. So and really behind of that physical picture is a certain representation theory, so that electron which we are discussing here can be treated in terms of rotations which around that orbits. So it's rotational subgroup, so we have some discrete eigenvectors for rotational subgroup. And what in general in this subgroup happen, this is so-called that creation and annihilation operator, so L ladder operator. They are also called because it's like on stairs and ladder, you're going up and down. So you have L plus and L minus operator. And with respect to certain operator Z, you have a such commutator relation in the Lie algebra. What this commutator relation implies? So let us assume let us evaluate what will be action of Z, operator Z, on the ladder operator applied to an eigenvalue, eigenvector of Z. Out of commutator formula, ZL plus can be replaced L plus Z and times lambda L plus. So that follow from that commutator formula, such a replacement. So we split it into two terms, so L plus Z and L lambda L plus. So because Vk was k eigenvector for Z tilde, so we replace it just by k times Vk, and when collecting things, we obtain that expression. So what happened? As you see, the first and end expression in this chain of identities, you get the Z applied to L plus Vk, produce L plus Vk again with some factor, so that became eigenfunction for Z tilde. So if you start from an eigenfunction Vk for Z tilde, you get another eigenfunction L plus Vk, and new eigenvalue is old eigenvalue lambda plus plus lambda plus. So old eigenvalue is Ik, so you add lambda plus to that old eigenvalue. So you obtain new eigenvector with new eigenvalue. So schematically, so we may put that ladder as follow. So you have eigenspace consisting of eigenvectors with value ik. So L plus produce ek plus lambda, and L minus put it to ek minus lambda. So L plus is increased level of energy, L minus decreased level of energy for this ladder. So this is what happened in usual situation, in particular when Z is a generator of subgroup K. So for subgroup K, that is how ladder operator is working. Actually, existence of ladder operators is relatively easy to check if we have well, just start from that condition. This is defining property for ladder operator. So let us look for a ladder operator for generator of subgroup K. So this is vector field Z in Lie algebra. So we have that basis A, B, Z. So put ladder operator to be having some coefficient A with A, B with B, and C with Z. And then write down the commutator property. You will get three equations. So coefficient A, B, C shall satisfy this identity for some lambda plus. So this is a linear system. Lambda is a parameter. A, B, C are unknown. Solution to this linear system, if you put compatibility condition for this linear system, then determinant is equal to zero. So this is homogeneous system, so determinant shall to be equal to zero. Compatibility condition here is what lambda squared plus 4 is equal to zero, or the only solution which we have here, of course, lambda is plus or minus 2i. So we need to introduce complex numbers to make here the existence of ladder operator for subgroup K, or its generator Z. So and ladder operator L plus will be such a linear combination. By the way, if you will look what this ladder operator is, this is exactly the operator which annihilate Mother wavelets for the Cauchy kernel. Coming back to previous slide, what happened if we have such annihilation operator? So at some value here, coefficient became zero. So when you go in this direction, at some point you get zero. So all that chain to the left disappear. You have only positive part, half chain, not infinite in both directions, but starting at some point and going up. And that is really connecting, coming back, is connected why in Taylor expansion we have only positive powers of Z. There is potentially you may have some here from minus infinity to infinity, so expanding over all integer powers, positive and negative. But analyticity, the condition which Cauchy-Riemann operator produce a zero, annihilate Mother wavelet, kill off all negative side. So it's from this chain, so all that part of the chain to the negative one is disappearing. So it's all that things are connected here. So one with another, Cauchy-Riemann operator with Taylor expansion with ladder operator. So there is nice connection between them. So now let's come to the situation where we wish to find ladder operator for subgroup A. So subgroup A, it's spanned by vector B. So you look for solution of this equation. Similarly, you start from arbitrary vector in the Lie algebra. So it's spanned by the basis with some coefficient A, B, C. If you write it down, you get a homogeneous system of three unknowns, A, B, C, with parameter lambda. And compatibility condition, when determinant is equal to zero for this homogeneous system, will be lambda squared is equal to 1. As you see, there is certain here suggestion in spirit of our geometrical study. Because if you are thinking just in terms of real or complex number, the solution of lambda square is equal to 1 is just plus or minus 1. This is the only thing which you can see. But if you will, and when rising and lowering operator will be like that. But if you are working in term of double numbers, you will know for lambda square equal to 1, there is another solution, j. J square also produce 1, and it's not plus minus 1. So you will have a second set of ladder operators. For double numbers, you have two sets of ladder operators. And when you have not a one-dimensional chain, you have two-dimensional lattice. So that real valued ladder operators, they act in horizontal direction. So it's increase eigenvalue by a real amount. But with if we use lambda equal plus or minus j, we will have the second set of ladder operators. They are acting in vertical direction. They increase or decrease eigenvalues by imaginary amount, factor of j, that amount. So instead of one-dimensional chain, you have here a set of lattice. And here situation is also interesting, because what you will have, you will, even if your operator will be what we did before, if this operator will be annihilated by L minus, and this is what condition we can put, that space not necessarily disappear, because you may arrive to this point using hypercomplex operators coming around, not by straight operator, but coming around. So that produce much more possibilities here. So it's not only like you have infinite chain to minus infinity plus infinity and you cut it in one place. Here you may have much more complicated shapes of what is non-zero on that two-dimensional lattice. Again, that is a thing which need to be investigated, and probably physical meaning of that eigenspaces in two-dimensional lattices need to be investigated. And finally, for subgroup n prime, we can do a similar search for the ladder operators which will work. So we have a system again of linear homogeneous equation with parameter lambda, and here parameter lambda have to satisfy to lambda square equal to 0. Again, if you limit it to real numbers, you know have only one value, lambda is equal to 0. But in this situation, lambda equal to 0 does not produce any shift. So if you remember, coming back, purpose of the lambda, what it's shift eigenvalue, it's produce eigenvector with different eigenvalue. If lambda is 0 here, no shift is produced. So in parabolic case, as we used to see, there is certain degeneracy. Ladder operator exists, but did not shift an eigenvector. But we may use another solution. So for any real t, t epsilon squared will be again produce 0. So that will be imaginary shift of the eigenvalues if we will produce ladder operator of this type. And so, as you see, what a summary of study of ladder operators here. If we study subgroup K, ladder operator cannot be constructed without complex numbers. So compatibility condition was lambda squared plus 4 equal to 0. So complex number are necessary. If we study next stage, parabolic one, when we are able to produce ladder operator without hypercomplex numbers, but they are not useful. So they do not produce shift of eigenvalues. And finally, In hyperbolic case, it's most richest situation. You have real ladder operators, and they are useful, they produce shift of eigenvalues, but on top of that you have a hyper-complex one. So it's you have useful combination of both of them. And finally, what probably good place to finish this lecture, this is what I called similarity and correspondence principle. What you may seen on many occasions during our lectures so far, you have the free subgroup within SL2R, KNA, and you may their role is rather similar. You may replace whatever you do with one subgroup, you can do with two others, but this time, if you are trying to make use of subgroup N and A as you used to have subgroup K, then you need to replace complex number by dual and double numbers. If you do such simultaneous shift from subgroup and for hypercomplex numbers, you are usually well done. So that is possible to make. And here is several that illustration. What for corresponding subgroup we have the linear fractional transformation in corresponding hypercomplex unit. Then we have corresponding rotations of the unit circles. Then there are unitary representations corresponding to that three different numbers. And finally, there are corresponding ladder operators with three numbers. So that is principle which summarizes somehow our finding in relation to analytic function theory. Okay.